Hello, good evening. It's another 5 weekends. Welcome to all my fellow travelers, photographers, and friends. And today, I will bring you to my next travel logs to Peru, the number 7 episode. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. It will be another exciting weekend for me, be able to share with you a very important historical regions in Peru, and it is given the name the Sacred Valley of Inca. From the name itself, you know very well this Sacred Valley of Inca is basically a center of Inca civilizations. So it will be another long episode or long travelogues today, which I'm going to share with you quite a number of interesting Inca archaeological sites or ruins. So first and foremost, in my sharing with you is a place called Pisac, and this Pisac is located between the Sacred Valley. And it's also considered the starting point of the Sacred Valley. And we also visit one of the Pisac town, which is very popular among the tourists because of its Sunday market. Right? And then we also visiting a very traditional market. I consider traditional, they've been claimed as the most traditional market in South America, and the name of this small little township is called Chinchero Town, right? And then we move on to another very important archaeological site or ancient Inca ruin is of the place called Ollantaytambo, right? And that begin with our travelogue proper today. A quick one, as usual, that the South Americas is where this nation, Peru, is located. And of course, Peru is a nation that actually border to 5 other nations, which basically is the Ecuador and Colombia, Brazil, Bolivia, and Chile, and as well as the western side is actually fronting the Pacific Oceans. And we are still around these Cusco regions. And as I mentioned in my earlier, the last episodes, that Cusco is the capital city of Inca Empire. And within these regions, you still can find quite a number of Inca ruins scattered along this so-called Sacred Valley. And today, the purpose of sharing with you is to give you an idea of how this Inca civilization is developed in these regions. And let's move on to another map. You can see that this from Cusco to another township called Ollantaytambo. And this region is basically classified as the Sacred Valley. And we are actually spending, as I said earlier, we spend quite a number of days around Cusco as to have a comprehensive understanding of the Inca civilization. And therefore, the Sacred Valley has an altitude range between 2,400 meters to 3,400 meters. That means there's approximately a 1,000 meter elevation differences from one point to the other. And why we say this area as a Sacred Valley? Now, the Sacred Valley of Inca is basically a region or a valley stretching from two important towns. One on the east is a Pisac town, to the west Ollantaytambo, of about 100 kilometer in length in the Andes of Peru, right? It's a stretch about a length of about, it's about 20 kilometer north of Cusco City. So we look at the map itself to have a clear understanding of the whereabout of this Sacred Valley of Inca. So this is a map here. You can see that on the between the area, a circle in red, you can see there are two townships. That is on the right, you can see the Pisac, and on the left, then you see the Ollantaytambo, right? And of course, Cusco is right at the lower portion. That's why it is just about 20 kilometer north of Cusco. And these are some of the general scenery of view of this Sacred Valley. Let's go about some detail about this Sacred Valley to have a better understanding of Inca civilization. Now, the Sacred Valley of Inca, as I mentioned earlier, that the during the colonial era, it was referred as a Valley of Yucay, right? It's another very famous archaeological zone in Peru. I wouldn't call it a site, but a zone because it covers quite a large area. This fertile valley is irrigated by the Urubamba River, and this valley supported a few civilizations, not only the Incas Empire, but also some other much earlier civilizations, such as the Chanapata civilization, the Kota-Kola, as well as the Kilki civilization, right? And of course, Inca Empire took over this valley in the year 1420. Now, the agriculture terrains here are known as indigenous, right? Are abundant in this valley. A remarkable sign of Inca civilizations, Sacred Valley was believed an area of royal estates and country homes of Inca Empire. The presence of Inca ruins in Pisac support this statement, right? Now, if you are a private traveler, just as a piece of advice, visiting Cusco and not joining any of the local tour, right? And if you want to cover all as many of these Inca ruins in this Sacred Valley, it's a wise way to get a tourist pass, right, to cover most of the entrance fees of the Inca ruins in this region. And the tourist pass, which in Spanish are named as Boleto Turístico de Cusco, is a bargain, you know, at a price of about USD 50 for a validity period of 5 days, which is good enough to cover the entire regions. But of course, the price is subject to change. So these are the images of the valley, the Sacred Valley. You can see the terrain's ground at the back of this image. I can understand how important this area is to the Inca Empire. You look at the greenery, and it's actually very fertile regions, and that's where they're able to support the population of the Inca Empire and all the subsequent earlier empire or civilizations. There are many villages and also ancient ruins that scatter here and there, and we have visited also few others, but because it's quite a small ancient ruins, so I did not make a report or share with you guys, because I find that it's not something very outstanding or unique in nature. But obviously, you can see that there's still the so-called typical feature of this ancient Inca ruin is actually all this stone wall, terraced stone wall, you can find here and there, right? Over the entire Sacred Valley. And now we are going to move on to another important area, right? And you can see that now the arrow that point in this map is the Pisac, you know. And the Pisac town is at the bottom, and at the arrow that pointing is the Pisac Inca Range. Now this Pisac Inca Range, or Inca Complex, as some people like to call it, is sited on a hilltop overseeing Pisac town at an elevation between 3,446 meters to 3,540 meters north of Cusco. So let's look at the location. This is actually the tourist illustrated map indicating around a Pisac region. And obviously from this image, you can see a terrain ground, and at the same time, at the point where the red arrow is pointing, is basically the Inca Range, actually is stood high above ground. So this is actually the entrance arch, the wooden entrance arch to this archaeological site, or actually the Inca Range. And this is actually the view of this Inca Range. Unfortunately, I did not really enter into this Inca Range because that there's quite a lot of climbing, and at these high altitudes, I try not to overexert myself. Of course, some of my tour mates are strong and young tour mates. They did make an attempt to visit this Pisac Inca Range. Now, but anyway, despite not much images to share, but important to note that this Inca Range, Pisac Inca Range, is the Peru most intact ancient Inca Range, a perfect example of Inca architectures. Now, this ancient city was destroyed, right, in the year 1530 by Spanish conquerors, right? So, and of course, it's not in a very good condition after it was destroyed. So more images of the surrounding, right? You can see the terrains. It was sited on a very beautiful valley. And at the same time, you still can find some old building here and there. I believe these are the small village. And then at the nearby hill, or the hill slope, we saw many hole or cave. And I was told this was a dug-in hole or cave, and it's believed that this cave or hole are the burial place of the Inca people. Let's see some of the images closer. You can see those holes on these hill slopes. Quite a number of them. And this is also the surrounding area, not far from the Pisac Inca Range. You can see everywhere, you can see all these stone terrace, stone wall. The mountain view around this valley. And of course, if there's a tourist, there will be people selling souvenirs. So along the route leading to this Pisac Inca Range, of course, you found that the local people are mainly the Quachua indigenous people. They are setting up their store on the floor, right, selling their handmade handicraft to the visitor. And you can see all of them are dressing in their traditional costume. Now, we are visiting the town below this Pisac Inca Range, and let's share a bit about this town, why it gets so popular. Of course, they get popular partly because of this Pisac Inca rain, but also partly due to their market in this town. Now, this Pisac is an Athens town located in the Sacred Valley. This town was built during or around 1570, that means around this time frame. The site next to Vilcanota River, right, at an altitude of about 2,972 meters above sea level, is 33 kilometers east of Cusco City. This tourist-oriented town is very popular among travelers and turned touristic mainly due to its Sunday market and the nearby Incas Ruins. Now, as Pisac market is been regarded as the best market in Peru, although this market opens on every Tuesday and Thursday, but they also open on Sunday, and the Sunday market is among the best, right? Because neither of these Tuesday or Thursday markets can match the atmosphere and magnitude of the Sunday market. On each Sunday, the indigenous Quachua community from surrounding area will gather here to sell their products, and they arrive mainly in their traditional clothing or costume. The Pisac markets have almost half of their store dedicated to handicraft, which include traditional musical instruments to alpaca sweaters, painting, etc., etc. And let's look at some of the image. So now you can see now we are now at the township below the right along the starting point of this Sacred Valley. And this is inside the township, inside the markets. You can see the buildings are very beautiful, colorful, decorated, and with an overhang wooden balcony. And this is some of the street that selling all kinds of souvenirs. And you can see that the number of stores is all fully packed with all the handicraft. And you can see one channel, right? A small water channel right at the middle of the street. You can see from this image. Right? You can see that if there's a street, there will be a water channel or drainage channel at the middle of the street. And interestingly, you know, on this copper paved street itself, beside the drainage channel, we found an entry point to one of the drainage channel is with a scorpion head, as seen in this image. I don't know why they put on a scorpion head on this entry point. But if any of our viewers who have any knowledge of that, please do share and make a comment in this episode, right? So you can see that the street are all cobblestone paved, and as well as the base of the buildings are all stone works. And this is actually the market, where actually selling all kinds of fruits. It's just like a wet market at one of the sections of the town, right? There's a marketplace. And these are some of the souvenir display on sale in some of the stores in this market. And a lot of painting. And I believe that actually all this painting painted by the indigenous people, the painter there, I mean the artist, is a very good reflection of the heritage and culture of Quechua people. very, very colorful and well-painted painting. And then move on from one market, we are moving on to another interesting market, and this is called the Chinchero market. Now, Chinchero market is located, of course, in a township also of the same name called Chinchero town. And this is the image show that the entry point, the entry arch to this local traditional market. In the early hours of the day, we arrived there, and of course, you can see that the crowd is not there yet, you know. But later on, when the crowd is built up, I will show you in the subsequent image. So let's know where exactly the location of this Chinchero town. Now, it's as where the location shown or pointed by the red arrow. So this is a location much closer to the Cusco. Now, Chinchero town is a small township located in the Sacred Valley, not far from Cusco. Chinchero market is a colorful local market in the town of Chinchero. Now, Chinchero market is one of the most traditional markets in South America, not only in Peru, but in South America. Most of the vendors are indigenous people, the descendants of Inca, and their main language is Quechua. Now, they come from the surrounding regions. The vendors come from surrounding regions. The market opened only on Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday as usual, just like the market in Pisac, right? They only open in these 3 days. The local, both the vendors and the buyers, are dressed up in their traditional costume while visiting the market. That makes this market very, very interesting. Now, this traditional market sells all kinds of local products and foodstuff, right? Including handicraft from the indigenous people. So let's see the images of the market. Now, later on, we found in the market, the crowd building up, and you can see that those people walking on the street, they are the buyer, right? They are the visitor, the local visitor, and they're all dressed in their indigenous costume. A very simple stall, you know, they just have a shed over it, and then everything was placed on the floor. So communication with them could be a problem because that they only speak Quechua language. So we have to use a sign, you know, the $5, you should put up a fine, you know, thing like that, you know. And the communication is always a challenge to visitor here to buy things from the local. You can see in this vegetable and fruit stall, you see the pumpkin, they are so big in size. Very, very interesting. A market that we spent about 2 hours here. No, it's a picture squad place for photographer. They also sell a lot of authentic food or snack, and exactly what you get from here is what exactly the local are consuming. Interestingly, this place is not, I do not find many visitors, foreign visitor. In fact, we are the few of them that are here. And I managed to bought some souvenir here. You can bargain and you can get quite a good price here compared to other places. You see, all of them are putting up their traditional hat. And this is the cheese sessions. And you can see this cheese is not as colorful as what you find in the Cusco City. I think this is the most original flavor of the cheese in this region. Most of the things selling here are all the local food stuff, vegetable, and so on. And a good thing to make a note here, my boats, my trekking boat or my jungle boats, smile at me. The base detached from the top. So you can see that there's a boat there with some tape on it itself. I'm having it repaired at this store. Right? This store is repairing all the shoe and boats. And as I seated there for about more than half an hour waiting for my boat to be repaired on the spot. So let's move out from this market and going to another very popular Inca ruins at the far end. Remember, Pisac is on the eastern side, and then on the western end of this Sacred Valley is the Ollantaytambo, the town Ollantaytambo. Pisac is a town on the eastmost of the Sacred Valley, and as far as Ollantaytambo is the westmost town in the Sacred Valley. Of course, further to that will be actually the Machu Picchu, right? Let's again go into some background of this Ollantaytambo, right? Now, Ollantaytambo is a village located in the Sacred Valley, which is about 60 km north of Cusco City. The village is sited along the Urubamba River at an altitude of 2,792 meters above sea level. This village got its popularity due to the presence of ancient Inca ruins. The Ollantaytambo's ruin, right? And this ruin is the second most well-preserved ruin in Peru. Now, Ollantaytambo ruin is a massive Inca fortress with large stone terrace on a hillside. Atop the hill is where the sun temple and religious buildings are located. It is believed that this Inca ruins was once a military, religious, and agriculture center of Inca Empire and the royal estate of the Emperor Pachacuti. In the street of these ruins are cobblestone paved with adobe dwellings. So this ancient city was divided into three distinct zones, right? And the terrain sections also of the name Puma Tolis, right, were the agriculture zone, and the lower link flat area are the residential or rather the township of this ancient reign. And at the highest point of the terrace is house the religious area. So distinctly, they divided in these three zones. As I'm sharing you the image later on, I will tell you which zone this falls under. Now, this Ollantaytambo town is still occupied. It's one of the oldest continuously occupied township since the 13th century. And over time, of course, this town undergone numerous alterations. So let's see the image here. So first of all, the location of this Ollantaytambo. You can see from the Cusco all the way stretched until the end is called Ollantaytambo. And the between these two towns is actually deemed to be the Sacred Valley. And up to the Ollantaytambo, you can see that we travel further to a place called Aquas Calentas. This actually is the foothill town, so small little townships where we put a night away for the visit, prepare for the visit of Machu Picchu, which I'm going to share with you in the next episode. So the location of this Ollantaytambo is as per this map shown where the arrow red pointed to, right? It's almost to the extreme left or extreme west, all right, of the Sacred Valley. So this is the townships before entering to the ancient Inca reign. So from far, you really see this Inca reign. You can see the terrace ground. Actually, the terrace was built on the hill slope. While the flatted area, the low-lying area where we stood and took my picture, this is actually the town area or residential or town area. Of course, this is a tourist spot. This is a tourist spot. You can find a lot of stores selling souvenir and local handicraft. So you are moving into the ancient range, and you can start looking at all these terrains, ground in this image. These are the agricultural zone. And the whole township are surrounded by mountains. And all these buildings look pretty new. Of course, it's been under numerous reconstructions over the years. And when we are midway in this terrace ground or the agriculture zone, and we look down, as you can see, the flat area is basically the town area or as well as residential area, right? And further out of it is actually the existing township. There's still the current living township of Ollantaytambo, right? This is actually the residential area which classified under the ancient rain region. So therefore, it's more for visitor to view. It's an archaeological site now. This is a view of the township. Over here, you still can find some fountains and ponds. Actually, that is where they collect the waters for use. And this place is basically the storehouse. It was built on the mid hills, next to the terrace regions. And as you move further up, above the terrace region at the highest point, you can see there are some buildings there. This the small little building atop the hill are basically the religious building. There's quite a number of steps to climb, and of course, again, I did not climb to the topmost regions. I'm only reached about two-thirds of it, you know, stop at the terrain's area. Surrounding view. And a point to note here, from here, if you want to visit the Machu Picchu, you can trek from here. There's a trekking trail from this Ollantaytambo all the way to Machu Picchu. And I was told the whole entire trekking trail will take at least about 6 or 7 days. Anybody want to take this try? I believe that some of the very young and energetic visitors may want to try. The starting point is from Ollantaytambo. So this is just the mountains range that actually enclosing this township. And I found a small little mobile vendors. I believe that this mother and her daughters was here to selling all the handicraft done by her family. This cute little kid. And of course, in this living township of Ollantaytambo, they also have a town square or center square. So at this center square area of this Ollantaytambo, there are quite a number of church, but this old church is the one just stood next to this town square. And it's a Catholic church, right? And the name of this church is St. James Apostle, right? Apostle. And this church have caught my attention, mainly due to the outstanding building architectures and decoration, both exteriorly and interiorly. So let's look at some of the images of this township, this old church. This is a view from the entrance, the external view. Quite a interesting entrance. And these are some of the exterior decoration and painting. You can see the roof work, the soffit of the roof, or rather is a soffit of the balcony above. And also you can see all the painting and column capitals on the wall. And you can see the soffit of the roof right above, the floor above. It's a two-story church. Interiorly, they have a very high ceiling, this church. Unfortunately, as usual, that they don't allow you to use flashlight, and inside is very, very dim, and I could not able to capture more images because quite a number of my images were blurred due to insufficient lighting, right? But anyway, I managed to have these two image capture interiorly because of the open windows. Where the light shine in. So this is about my journey to this Sacred Valley of Inca, where is the center of the Inca civilizations. And again, as usual, I have to thank you for staying until this hour. And please, if you are entertained, and you like my travel channel, please do subscribe, right, share, and as well give me a thumb up. In the coming episodes, I will bring you to another interesting place in Peru, right? And of course, two more episodes to go, and I will wrap up my journey to Peru, and of course, I'm going to bring you to another nation, and of course, this time the nation will be much closer to Malaysia, but maybe further away from a friend of mine who are staying in Canada, in USA, in Europe. Anyway, please stay strong and stay safe, and thanks you for supporting my travel channel. I hope to see you again in the coming week, and bye.